Hi, I'm Denise Schwab, Extension Beef Specialist for Northeast Iowa, and today I'm going to visit with you about pre-calving nutrition on those heifers that we are developing. First of all, we know that heifers that calve in the first 21 days of the calving cycle are more likely to come back into heat earlier, rebreed earlier, and stay in the herd longer, and as a result produce more pounds of calf. We also know that first calf heifers tend to take a little longer to return to estrus than mature cows, and nutrition is one of those key factors that helps us to achieve growth and reproduction in first calf heifers and keep them in the herd longer. Why is nutrition important? Well, first of all, for growth. We know that by putting a target or setting a target of 85% of mature weight at calving time, it gives us a goal to shoot for. But maybe more important than weight is body condition score on those heifers to ensure that they are going to come back and cycle and rebreed and stay in the herd longer. Also, adequate nutrition ensures that we have the ability of that cow to deliver the calf, produce milk or lactate, and recycle. We often get asked why 85% of mature weight. Well, mostly it's just to make sure that we have those heifers in a positive growth curve and a positive plane of nutrition from breeding time on into calving season. And what it does is it gives us a number or a weight, a gain goal to achieve in terms of setting up our nutrition programs and our rations. We do want to be careful, however, that we don't overfeed those heifers, because as we get them too fat, we can cause more problems from a reproductive standpoint as well and calving yeast standpoint. So we want to make sure we aren't wasting feed, because that also can affect reproduction if we're overfeeding. But let's look at an example. If our mature cow weight is about 1,350 pounds, then our goal at breeding time, 65% of that is 875 pounds, and our goal at calving of 85% of mature weight would have us at about 1,150 pounds at calving. And that tells us we need to have those heifers gaining 275 pounds in the 280 days from breeding to first calf. In other words, gaining 0.95 or just short of a pound per head per day to reach our goal. As I mentioned, body condition score may be as important or more important than weight, and here's one of the studies that points to that. It looked at heifers that were body condition score 3 to 7, and it looked at the postpartum interval, or the number of days from calving to first heat. And you can see once we get cows in a condition score 5 or 6 and above, we're somewhere around 50 to 60 days postpartum interval. But those heifers that were condition score 3 and 4 were looking at 70 to 90 days before they would start to cycle, therefore impacting our ability to keep them on a yearly calving system. Another study that looked at condition scoring looked at how many of those heifers actually bred and conceived on that second pregnancy. And cows that were in a condition score of 6, almost 98% of those heifers conceived for that second calf. When we dropped down to a body condition score 5, we lost 20% of them. Only 80% of those heifers conceived for a second calf. And when we were a body condition score 4, only about 55% of those heifers actually conceived that second calf. So one of our objectives to keep these heifers in the herd longer, body condition score becomes really important to make sure we have adequate nutrition for them. Now, some folks will say, well, yeah, but if I feed them too much, then I'm going to have calving difficulties. And this was a study from the U.S. Meat Animal Research Center that looked at exactly that. The medium group here were cows that were fed to meet NRC requirements from up to calving time. The low group were ones that were fed below the nutrition or energy requirement. And the high group were ones that were overfed energy. And you can see by the blue bar that birth weight did increase as we went from the low energy to the medium to the high energy group. But what's more important than just body weight is calving difficulty. And if you look at the red bars, you can see that as we overfed the heifers in that high energy group, we did not affect calving difficulty. But if you look at that low energy group, we had significantly more calving difficulty from those underfed animals than we did from the overfed animals. So excess energy will cause a heavier calf, but is not necessarily going to cause an increase in calving difficulty. Now, there have been a few studies that looked at what about using fat in the diet, and this is a study, I believe, from Missouri that looked at 5% added fat to a heifer diet pre-calving. And what they saw is that they saw a tendency for a few more of those heifers to be bred for their second pregnancy, but the effect was very dependent on how long they were on that high-fat diet and what was their body condition score coming into that. For those heifers that were very thin, it did help to increase their cycling at the start of breeding season by feeding some additional fat. But again, that objective was 5%. What they saw as above 5% added fat had tended to have an impact on intake and reduced intake. So for those heifers that are thin, adding fat may help. For those heifers that are in a body condition score 6, probably isn't necessary. We don't want to forget about vitamins and minerals, although our focus tends to usually be on energy first and protein second. We do want to at least acknowledge that minerals and vitamins are very important. They're used in every type of a cycle. Here are some of the requirements, both for that third trimester pre-calving and then also for the post-calving lactation requirements. You can see that many of them do increase significantly as you go from third trimester gestation into lactation. And just want to mention, you know, some of the ones that may be of concern, if you're feeding a lot of co-products, you do want to pay attention to your calcium phosphorus levels and ratios as well as sulfur. If you're feeding hay that's more than a year old, you probably want to pay specific attention to vitamin A levels. And if you're in areas that are short in selenium, again, you might want to pay attention to the selenium and vitamin E levels. Rumensin and our other ionophores are a tool to help us to put on that weight at a less expensive cost. What we see with the ionophores is about 5 to 10% less feed intake on forage diets. More important when feed costs are higher than it is when feed costs are lower, but either way, it's a significant improvement. We do tend to see about 10% improvement in gain for developing heifers that are fed ionophore. There has been some research that looked at it, does it have an impact on cycling or pregnancy rates, and we've seen mixed results from those studies. We do also want to say that Rumensin is approved for use in both mature cows as well as heifers. Bovatec is approved only for use in heifers. So in summary, pre-calving nutrition has a direct impact on both reproduction and herd longevity. We want to have a target of about 85% of mature weight at calving time, as well as a body condition score of 6 to ensure that those heifers have a better chance of cycling and staying on a 12-month cycle. Energy does not cause dystocia, but lack of energy does. And again, just a reminder that ionophores result in less feed needed and put on more gain. Just a reminder, if you have further questions on this topic, please feel free to contact one of the beef program specialists that you see here. You can get all of our contact information off of the iowabeefcenter.org webpage. We'll have this as well as other videos related to both heifer development, first year and second year, on our YouTube video page, and you can see the address there. Thanks for your time.